brain cells, as you know, are called neurons. And neurons have got three very important purposes. They, first of all, carry information. So when you're teaching the student, the information is going from the one neuron to another neuron to another neuron. Secondly, neurons carry our thoughts, our beliefs, and our feelings. And thirdly, neurons carry our neurotransmitters, which is our brain chemistry. Your role as a teacher or a parent is to know how to help the child make as many neural pathway connections as possible. Because in that way, the child is using more and more of their brain. So essentially, really, what we want you to do is know, how do I take this student or this wonderful child of mine and engage with them, teach them, have a conversation with them in a way that does this to the child's brain, where neural pathways are connecting with many, many neural pathways. What happens with our traditional teaching is that we teach like that. So we keep children stuck in a limited number of neural pathways connecting with each other. We want to be able to open up that brain and have many neural pathways connecting with each other, and we'll talk about how to do that later today. Truth of the matter is, some children are wired differently. And so the pathways that carry the information are poorly organized. As I said, I'm wired differently. And they don't respond in exactly the same way as neurotypical children. So that is the truth. Teachers can wire and rewire the child's brain. They can create new neural pathways, which we just spoke about. They can increase, you can actually increase the size and the density of the child's brain and change the structure and the function of the brain. Isn't it just awesome? Just knowing that as a parent, if your child is not stuck, as a teacher, to know that you can open up the neural pathways, that you can rewire and change the function and the size and the density of the brain, isn't this just the most amazing thought? So, the latest scientific research proves that we can transform students' brains into their biological best, which of course is different for every child. And as I've said, no child needs to be stuck at all. You just need to know how to do that.